Okay, so in this video, I'll be showing you how to export a model from Revit to 3ds Max, then from 3ds Max to Lumion. And you might need this in case maybe the installation of your live sync was not successful. Then you might need this method as an alternative method, so that in case your live sync, maybe something happened and the live synchronization could not work, then the next alternative you have is to export from Revit to 3ds Max, because Lumion does, you can export directly from Lumion, but the materials will not work. The material will be exported as one entity, which will not work. So for you to be able to export directly, then you need to take it to 3ds Max first. And to do that, all you need to do is you go to the application tab here, then you are going to export. In this case, you are going to take it to FBX file. So select the folder and you give it a name, Lumion_3ds Max. Tutorial. Okay, so you can save it. You hit save. Now I'll save it as FBX file. So the next thing is I'm going to launch my 3ds Max so that I can import that model to 3ds Max. So I've launched my 3ds Max application. And the version I'm using is 3ds Max 2017. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this application menu, and I will hit on this drop down, and I'm going to go to import. Then I will hit link FBX file. Then I will go to the folder. Here is the folder. So I'm going to select that FBX file we saved before and hit open. Then this is one of the trick that you will need. You will see this preset, so make sure it's on material, so that all the material you set in Revit will be separated. If you use combined by Revit category, then the material might be lumped together. You will not be able to separate the material in Lumion, so make sure you are on combined by Revit material, so that the material you have set in Revit will be separated. They will be categorized based on different materials you are using, so that the application of material in Lumion will be easier for you, either in Lumion or in 3ds Max will be easier for you. So having selected that, we are going to hit attach this file and wait for it to attach. I will hit yes. Then I'm going to close this. I will delete this camera because it's of no use to me. Then I will delete this. It's of no use to me. Now this is our 3D. Let's hit Alt W to view this. Okay, so this is our Revit model in 3ds Max. Now you can see all the materials are separated. All the material are categorized differently. So having done this, we are going to save it. So let's save it as, well, we'll save it as Lumion tutorial. FB X. Then I'm going to save it and make sure you know the folder you are saving it in so that you can from Lumion go to that folder. And this knowledge is very, very important for you because as a 3D visualizer, there are some models that may be in FBX files or that may be in 3ds Max file that you need it in Lumion, so you need to know how to export it to Lumion. So having saved it, you are going to go to your Lumion and you are going to open a new project, and we can select any of these. Let me select this mountain range and wait for it to load. Okay, now that it has loaded, you are going to make sure you are on import file, imported model, and we are going to hit import, and you are going to go to that folder I saved mine in scenes, and here I'm going to select the type of file. By default it's selected sketchup file, but the file I want is 3ds Max file, so I'm going to look for it. Okay, this is 3ds file and I'm going to select that. Oh, it didn't show. Okay, let's select this. Okay, here it is. This is, let's look for it. We'll look for it among this file. We are looking for L Lumion tutorial. Okay, this is it. So we are going to open it and we are going to leave it in main file and check this mark. Okay, now that it has loaded, we are simply going to place it on this center point just once. Then we are going to click on this arrow button so that we can escape from that, or you can simply hold on escape key. And once you have escaped, you are going to look for the model by scrolling backward. You can use S key to shift away from you and use A key. You can press the two of them, it will be shifting backward and to the right simultaneously. So if you want it to shift faster, you add shift to it. With that, you add the shift key, the movement will be faster. Okay, this is it here. You can see the file will imported from 3ds Max is different from the appearance, is a little bit different from that of Revit and SketchUp. You can see this looks just black or dark gray, something like that. So having done this, let's save this camera first so that we can always go back to it. Let's go to our camera, then I'm going to zoom forward a little bit, and that was too much. Let me go move the, I can use S to move it backward, S and shift to make it faster. I can use E to move it up. Okay. Then I'm going to save this camera view. I'm going to store this camera. Okay, so that camera is saved. Let's see whether we can work on the material. To work on the material, you simply click on this build mode and simply select this material, this icon for material, and by the time we hover our cursor over the model, you can see it's selecting based on their materials. That means this work. So all we need to do is to apply the materials. So I'm going to select this first one, and I'm going to apply material. I'm going to go to outdoor, then I'm going to select this plaster. I will select this first one. I just want to show you a preview. Okay, you can see the material is applying, it's working. All right, so I'm not going to do all that in this one, just to show you how to apply all the materials. So from here you can apply all the materials in according to how you want it. But this is where we are going to stop this video. Thank you for watching this video, and see you in the next video. Bye.